breakfast news.
The image is quintessential Connecticut, the beautiful building rising up from the shores of the Connecticut River that in the summer is bustling with boat traffic. In the fall, it's set against a backdrop of the orange, red, and yellow hues of the season.
And on any given night, if you listen closely, you can hear the music from within. Maybe it's Annie singing "The Sun Will Come Out Tomorrow," or Dorothy contemplating a place somewhere over the rainbow.
The Goodspeed Opera House has never hosted a true opera, but since the building's beginnings back in the late 1800s, it has been home to many a musical, providing very talented artists an intimate stage to work their crafts, and for some, giving them stepping stones to stardom and careers on the Great White Way.
There have been retail stores in the first floor in the lobby going way, way back. They, you know, delivered grain and other items out of the basement because the river was right there and you could pull the boat up next to it.
The Goodspeed Opera House was built back in 1876 by businessman and banker William Goodspeed. Goodspeed had a theater built on the upper floors. Actors would come in by steamboat, some from New York, to perform. Other businesses operated on the lower levels. Here's the building back in Goodspeed's day. This picture dates to the 1880s, horse-drawn carriages and all. And look at the two carriages in this picture. Over time, tenants changed. In fact, during World War I, the building was used as a militia base. 2 decades later, in the 1940s, it was home to a general store. But it fell into disrepair, and the plan was to demolish it. A group of preservationists stepped in before it was too late, raising the capital for a restoration. These pictures are from 1960. The theater is gutted and ready for the rebuild. Within just a couple of years, it was up and running again. This is opening night, 1963. And this is a telegram from then-President John F. Kennedy from the White House in Washington, D.C., congratulating the theater on its opening and wishing it a, quote, successful season and lively future, end quote. From that opening on, the musicals, yes, Goodspeed does only musicals, have continued to unfold on stage. From the Fantastics in 63 to Holiday Inn in 2014, from Shenandoah in 74 to Annie in 76, those two musicals started here at the Goodspeed and became big Broadway successes. 21 shows Goodspeed developed ultimately made their way to the Great White Way by way of East Haddam. And that's the hope of the current production, Chasing Rainbows, the story of how Judy Garland came to be Dorothy in The Wizard of Oz. There are many more musicals that grace the very small stage that is the Goodspeed. You know it's small, right? How small? Here's executive director of Goodspeed Musicals, Michael Gennaro.
The stage is maybe only twice as big as the room we're in, and the room we're in is not very big. When you go into that little jewel box of a theater that was built in the 1800s, the immediacy of the audience to the performers is what makes it unique, because there are roughly 400 seats and you are right on top of the performance. And because the stage is not that deep and there are no wings and there is no backstage, you are actually right in the mix of what's going on. The performances are right there in front of you, so you really feel as if you're, you know, instead of being in the, you know, 50th row of the theater, you're maybe 10 feet away from somebody.
Some very famous people performed on this very stage. Andrea McArdle was Annie. Christian Chenoweth performed in Strike Up the Band.
The great Raul Julia, you know, such a great actor in his own right. Mickey Dolenz from the Monkees. Donna McKechnie, who really came to fame with A Chorus Line.
Remember Jack Wagner from General Hospital and Melrose Place? He was here. So was Connecticut's own James Vanderbeek of Dawson's Creek fame. Singer Ariana Grande was just 15 when she was in the musical 13. But the Goodspeed is more than just the theater within the opera house that you get to by ascending that beautiful central staircase. What you might not realize is the Goodspeed is almost a campus with operations throughout East Haddam and beyond, including the nearby Norma Terrace Theater in Chester. We're talking 40 buildings.
The facilities that this organization has, the resources for building things, sets, costumes, whatever, are probably enough to fuel three theaters.
We visited the set shop as they were were getting ready for Chasing Rainbows. The nail guns were popping. The saws were on standby. A worker was sanding. A piano was being prepped near the props area. All the guts had to come out. They were too heavy. Across the way in a different building, the paint shop, where set pieces were at various stages of completion. There was staining underway, painting too. This artist is texturizing a large set piece. In this example, it's Kristen Roberts, creates the desired look for each scene, and then small-scaled models are built for reference. Here's the scene in the diorama. Here it comes to life on the stage. It's really fascinating. Goodspeed Musicals provides housing for the actors while they're here. They operate something called the Mercer Colony in the winter for musical theater writers. Great things have come out of there, including Chasing Rainbows.
If you're blue and you don't know.
And then there's the costume shop. They don't mess around.
The costume collection, probably other than the West Coast and the movie world, I doubt there's anything close to what we have, which is well over 200,000 costumes.
Many belong to Goodspeed. Some come here from Broadway. They're all safely stored in this huge, environmentally controlled new facility. And it's just packed. There are aisles upon aisles upon aisles of clothes. There are gowns that glitter, gowns with intricate beadwork and appliques. Look at this one. Gorgeous. There are boxes upon boxes of hats. There are halos and headbands. There's an entire room filled with shoes. High heel, low heel, boots from every era. There are lots of dress shirts and military dress jackets. Recognize this gorgeous cape from Sunset Boulevard, complete with plumes of peacock feathers? And of course, there's this. It's one of several of the red dresses Annie so famously wore first here on this beautiful one-of-a-kind stage before the production made its way to Broadway.
Tomorrow,
See, it's very inspiring.
And it's right here in Connecticut.